Okay, hello and welcome to another complex numbers question. So the question is, given a complex number z, which is not real, and if the absolute value of z is equal to 1, prove that w equals z minus 1 divided by z plus 1 is a purely imaginary number. Okay, so I'll be showing you two different ways of solving the question. The first one is a purely algebraic method, and the second one involves some geometry. So let's have a look at the algebraic method first. So an important fact which we'll use in the algebraic method is the fact that a product of a number z and its conjugate is equal to the absolute value of z squared. The product of a complex number z and its conjugate. In this case, the magnitude of z is equal to 1, so the magnitude of z squared will be 1 squared equals 1. And we have the conjugate of z is equal to 1 divided by z. Okay, to prove w is purely imaginary, what we can do is prove that w, the conjugate of w, is equal to negative of w. And the reason we can prove this, if we draw the complex plane, we can see if w is purely imaginary, its conjugate is a reflection about the x-axis. And the conjugate will be equal to negative w. So the conjugate will equal negative w whenever w is purely imaginary. Okay, so to calculate the conjugate of w, we're going to have the conjugate of z minus 1 divided by z plus 1. And a property of conjugates is the conjugate of z minus 1 divided by z plus 1 is the same as doing the conjugate of z plus 1 divided by, I should say z minus 1, conjugate of z minus 1 divided by the conjugate of z plus 1. And again, the same rule applies to addition. So the conjugate of z minus 1 is the same as the conjugate of z minus the conjugate of 1. And the conjugate of 1 is just 1 itself. And we're dividing by the conjugate of z plus 1, which is the same as the conjugate of z plus. The conjugate of 1 is just 1. Okay, and remember, the conjugate of z is equal to 1 divided by z. So now we have this. And now we can multiply the numerator and denominator by z. And now we have 1 minus z divided by 1 plus z. This is the same as the negative of z minus 1 divided by z plus 1. And this is the same as the negative of w. The negative of w is the same as this expression. So now we've successfully proven that the conjugate of w is the same as negative w. And from this, it follows that w is purely imaginary. So this is the algebraic solution. Now we can have a look at the geometric solution. So in the geometric solution, I will draw the complex plane again. I have the complex plane. Now mark the points 1 here and minus 1 here. Okay. And remember, since the magnitude of z is equal to 1, it means that z is on the unit circle. So we can put the point Z somewhere here on the unit circle. Okay, and now number, if you look at the numerator of the fraction for W, it's Z minus one. This can be represented by a vector going from one to Z. So that represents the complex number Z minus one. And also the number Z plus one, which is on the denominator, can be represented by a vector going from minus one to Z. Okay. If you have a look at the arguments of the numbers Z minus one and Z plus one, the argument, which is the angle made with the plus X axis, the argument of Z minus one is going to equal this value, this angle alpha over here. And the argument of Z plus one will equal this value beta over here. Okay, what we can also see is Z is on a circle with a diameter going. The diameter is the line between minus one and one. So since the line from minus one to one is a diameter, it follows that the angle subtended by the diameter is 90 degrees. So the angle formed over here is 90 degrees. And also the exterior angle. If you have a look at this triangle, I'll label it ABC. So triangle ABC, if you have a look at this exterior angle, the angle alpha is the exterior angle, and it means that alpha must equal the sum of these two interior angles. So alpha must equal beta plus 90 degrees. So it follows alpha minus beta must equal 90 degrees. Okay, and now if you have a look at W, if you want to calculate the argument of W, that's the argument of Z minus one divided by Z plus one. But a property about arguments is the argument of Z minus one divided by Z plus one is the same as the argument of Z minus one minus the argument of Z plus one. And the argument of Z minus one is alpha. And the argument of Z plus one is beta. And we already previously showed that alpha minus beta is 90 degrees. So we have 90 degrees over here. Or we could also use radians and write pi over two as the argument. So, but the argument of W is pi over two. And if the argument is pi over two, if we draw it again, it means it makes a 90 degree angle with the plus X axis. So W will look like this. So W is a purely imaginary number. And also there's a second case where you could also have Z down here. So Z could also be down here, and the geometry and the calculations are almost the same, except you'll end up getting the argument is negative pi over two instead of pi over two. And you'll have W down here in the second case where Z is down here. Okay, so that concludes the two different methods of solving this question of trying to show a number is purely imaginary. So hope you all enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.